this episode of GTV, we will be discussing GTV Visits Wildcat TV, staff highlight, ways to give this holiday, GTV challenge, and reflection winners. Hey Grizzlies, welcome back to another episode of GTV. I'm Rihanna Monterosa.
And I'm Emily Caton.
Last week, me and our fellow GTV members went to the high school to learn about Wildcat TV.
It was an amazing trip. I learned so much.
Let's go to Jalissa to learn more.
Hey Grizzlies, I'm Jalissa Abbott and we're here at the Wildcat TV studios with our whole GTV crew. We're going to be learning from the high schoolers. Let's go check it out.
Says she tired, little money, need a big boy. Pull up 20-inch blades like I'm little
Hey guys, I'm Zoe. I'm a senior. It's my first year watching TV.
Hi everyone, I'm Aislinn.
Hi, I'm Ash. I'm a junior. This is my first year in Wildcat TV. And
I'm Elise. I'm a senior. It's my first year in Wildcat TV.
Hey y'all, I'm Sky. I'm a senior. It's my second year on the team.
Kaden, I'm a junior. This is my first year. And
Hello,
I'm Bella.
I'm Kinsey,
I'm senior,
second year.
My name is River, and I'm a senior.
Hey, River!
Hey, River!
Hey, River! Hey, River.
Yeah,
I'm
Tim.
This is my second year at Wildcat TV.
Hi, my name's Sydney, I'm a junior, and this is my first year.
And Mr. Marble?
I'm here with Mr. Marble, the Wildcat TV teacher. What do you enjoy most about this class?
Well, I think it allows for a lot of creativity from students, so you get to interact with them in creative ways, and you really get to know students when you're working with them on projects every single week, and they can take this class for multiple semesters, and so I really enjoy just getting to know the students.
What's your least favorite thing about this class?
Ooh. Oh man, what do I pick from the list? No, I'm just kidding. I think probably one of the challenges is that every week what we do in this class is shown to pretty much the entire school district. So it would be like a math teacher, and if every week the test scores of their students were sent out for everybody to look at, it's a little bit intimidating because everybody gets to judge, you know, how your class is doing because they get to see it every week.
My piece of advice would be don't be afraid to ask questions.
What I would like to tell you guys is no idea is a bad idea.
The thing I would tell you guys is something that I actually started with, and it's just to relax in front of the camera.
The piece of advice that I would use is just to keep trying new things.
I just want to talk about making your story really interesting.
And my piece of advice would be just be confident on camera, like it's awesome.
And I guess my advice would be to step out of your comfort zone.
The information you're giving, find a way to, even though if it's a long sentence, make it seem like a short segment.
And I just wanted to talk about how you should definitely put effort into your stories.
So my advice is to just not let a task or an idea you have seem too challenging or like something you can't do.
And just like how Caitlin and Caitlin said that it's gonna take a lot of work and effort to get this stuff done. You gotta do a lot of dedication into it and put a lot of work into it.
The thing about Wildcat TV is you have to be dedicated and you have to put your priorities straight. I mean,
my advice to you guys would probably be to do prior proper planning.
39th grade. One of the things for Wildcat TV, that we look for is people who want to put in effort. Okay, are you gonna want to put in effort every single week, every single story? No, that's not realistic. Okay. It's not gonna happen every single time.
What do you do to keep your hair looking nice?
Well, use a variety of different products. Shampoo. I like to shampoo my hair at least once every 3 or 4 weeks, and lots of gels and pastes and stuff.
Do you use coconut oil? It's really good for your hair.
Who doesn't? Like, am I right?
It's like a good massager.
That's right. And it's like a party for your head.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means. That's the best question I've ever been asked.
That was awesome.
Me and Dre came for the when I got quiet, all of y'all disappeared. Before I dropped Sony, none of y'all really care. Now they always say congratulations to the kid.
I got one now. Always going for it, never pump. Fourth down, last call, Hail Mary, Prescott, touchdown, hey. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. 100 deep when I roll like the army. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. Yeah, your grandma will probably know me. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. Said she tired of little money, need a big boy. Pull up 20 inch blades like I'm Lil Troy. Now it's everybody flocking, need a decoy. Shorty mixing up the vodka with the liquor. G-Wagon, 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 G-Wagon. All the housewives pulling up. I got a lot of toys. 720S pumping Fallout Boy. You was so in the beginning. Back when I was feeling unforgiving. I know I pissed you off to see me winning. See the hit glue in my mouth and I be grinning. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. 100 deep when I roll like the army. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely.
Something I learned at Wildcat TV was that you should put dimension in your shot and not have it just like a plain wall.
I learned at Wildcat TV how to set up an interview and how to act natural on camera.
What I learned at Wildcat TV is how to set up different angles for when you're about to film and how to make a clone of yourself.
I learned a new way how to download music.
I learned to be fearless on camera.
I learned how to set up a shot and use a storyboard.
When we went to Wildcat TV, I learned new editing tricks.
My mind is blown from getting to know some of the high schoolers and all the new information I learned. Signing off from GTV, I'm Jalissa Abbott, now back to you in the studio.
My favorite subject is ELA.
Yeah, me too. I love all the ELA teachers I have throughout all the years.
Holly is covering a staff highlight. Let's get it.
Hey Grizzlies, I'm Holly Woods, and today we are going to be interviewing ELA teachers. Let's go check it out. What's your name and what subject do you teach?
My name is Jessica Payton and I teach 6th grade reading and 7th grade ELA.
I'm Mr. Christensen. I teach 6th and 7th grade ELA.
I'm Kara Larson. I teach 7th grade ACT skills, 8th grade ACT skills, and 8th grade ELA.
Holly Russell, 7th and 8th grade ELA.
Kyle Legg, 6th grade ELA, 7th grade ELA.
Why did you want to be an ELA teacher?
I had a 7th grade ELA teacher that changed my whole perspective on reading and writing, and so I wanted to do that eventually for one of my students.
I like reading and writing a lot.
I wanted to be an ELA teacher because I enjoy reading and writing, and I've always enjoyed teaching people. I used to teach my younger siblings when I was little.
I've always liked reading, and I thought when I got to be an ELA teacher, I would get to teach reading and spend my days reading.
What is your favorite book?
Oh my gosh, it's like asking your favorite movie. I have so many favorite books. My very first book that I finished, though, was Harry Potter. So I guess that holds a special place in my heart.
My favorite book is Hatchet by Gary Paulson.
I love reading the Harry Potter series.
Actually, I have two different kinds of books. One's historical fiction by Ken Follett, where I follow four different characters from 1908 to 1906 and how their lives are interwoven. And then my other one would be the Clifton Chronicles by Jeffrey Archer.
What is your favorite hour?
Well, I love all of my hours, but my favorites are probably fifth and sixth hour.
My advisory, because they rock!
Second hour with Bella Boswell and all other hours, but not really all other hours.
My favorite class or hour, that's difficult to decide. It kind of depends on the day.
What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
I don't like ice cream, but I love chocolate chip cookies.
Cookie dough.
Rocky road.
Peppermint or vanilla?
And a quick shout out to Miss Duval, who we couldn't interview because she is on maternity leave.
Thanks, teachers. Signing off from Grizzly TV, I'm Holly Woods. Now back to you in the studio.
I remember all the great times I had as a baby.
Yeah, like playing with toys and napping all day and eating baby food. Baby food. Anyways, our next GTV challenge is Guess That Baby Food.
Hey Grizzlies, it's Aurora Jordan here. It's that time of the episode, the GTV challenge. Here are our raffle winners.
The challenge is... the baby food challenge. Let's go check it out.
Hey Grizzlies, welcome to the studio challenge. Today, these ladies will be trying out baby food blindfolded. Let's get into it.
Well, that was something. Make sure you buy your raffle tickets, Grizzlies. Can't wait to see the next challenge. Signing off for GTV, I'm Aurora Jordan. Now back to you in the studio.
It is now time for this week's weekly announcements,
which now includes our monthly Grizzly shout-out from our Grizzly Raffles. Keelan, take it away.
Hey, Keelan.
Yes.
Can you take this to the gym for me, please?
Sure.
Hey, Grizzlies. I'm Keelan Johnson, and today I have to take these announcements and birthdays to the gym. Let's go.
On Monday, December 9th at 7 p.m., there's a choir concert. On Tuesday, December 10th, there is a district spelling bee at 7 o'clock p.m. On Monday, December 9th, Tuesday, December 10th, and Wednesday, December 11th, the boys and girls A and B basketball teams have a tournament.
I'm 6th grade, and I have never been in one school for more than a year. I moved every single year since kindergarten, and it just sucks.
Hi, my name is Layton. I'm in 6th grade, and I just wanted to say have a great Thanksgiving, and everyone else, stay safe, because everyone's going to be traveling, and I like turtles and food.
I like mac and cheese, and I'm a dancer, and I can do a back handspring.
Congratulations to all the reflection winners.
Good job, guys. I could never do that.
Well, let's go get the scoop on reflections.
Hey, Grizzlies. I'm Jordan Blackburn, and recently we found out who the winners of the PTSA Reflection Contest are. Let's go talk to them about their experience.
PTA Reflections is a national arts contest that National PTA puts on, and it's to encourage students to get involved in the arts and be creative. So the showcase is the Blue Springs School District Showcase, and it is next Wednesday, December 4th from 6 to 8. And it is an activity that all the kids who win at each one of the schools who win the top three or honorable mention get to have their work displayed there so everybody can come and see it. Most common categories are photography, literature, and visual arts. They also have film production and music composition and dance choreography, but those are ones that typically people don't participate in because I think they're a little bit harder.
Hi, my name is Kylie Zimmerman, and I got second place in the visual arts category for the PTA Reflections. I chose to enter in the category because for the past 2 years I've always wanted to do something art related, and then I finally decided to do it this year and, you know, somehow got second place.
Hi, I'm Haley Starwall, and I won first place in the visual arts category for the PTA Art Reflections. I chose to enter in visual arts because I had a dream the night before it was announced about my emotions, like they came out of my face in vivid colors and killed me. And then it was announced the next day, and I was like, this is why I had this dream.
My name is Prisha Patel. I'm in 7th grade. I entered in photography. I got first place.
On Wednesday, December 4th, all the reflection winners from every school in the district had a gallery to showcase their pieces. We saw entries in dance, photography, visual arts, literature, music composition, and more. Reflections is a way for students to express their creativity in a fun and competitive way. Students who placed in the district have a chance of competing at state level and then possibly moving on to nationals.
Thanks, Grizzlies. Congratulations. You all did an amazing job. Now, signing off from GTV, I'm Jordan Blackburn, and back to you in the studio.
That's all for this episode. Signing off from GTV, I'm Emily Caton.
And I'm Brianna Montrose.
And remember, Grizzlies, greatness happens here.